Here's a quick and dirty way of changing the brakes. A quick overview real quick. We're changing brakes on an 09 Chevy Tahoe. If you don't know how to get your tire off, then you probably don't need to be doing your own brakes. Anyway, first of all, you need to change take these bolts out here, your caliper bolts. They're the ones with the little rubber gasket right here. And that will allow you to get your caliper off of your caliper brackets. So these are 19 millimeter. And if you're going to change your rotors too, you have to take off your caliper itself, or your caliper bracket, which is two 18 millimeter bolts. Where is the other one? I got right here. My finger's at. So this is for just taking off the caliper and doing brake pads. This is for changing rotors too. Nothing is actually wrong with my rotors. I just don't like how they're rusty. So you'll see what I'm replacing them with. I know a lot of times brake pads should, or clips, your hardware should be okay. But I like getting new hardware every single time. High quality brake pads should come with new hardware. If not, I would see about getting, you can buy it for a few dollars. I'm sure you can buy a kit full of them. Another thing we want to do, take out your slide pads, or your slide pins. I don't care what the grease looks like on there. Wipe it off and replace it. I like using synthetic brake grease. There's a purple kind at Napa. I don't recall the brand name, but the stuff is actually purple, and that's rated for like 3,000 degrees or something. Which, if these brakes ever see 3,000 degrees, there's a problem. I think this here is rated for to 600 degrees. So like the 3000 stuff is just absolutely ridiculous. But this is a good synthetic brake grease. It's not like it's much cheap stuff you get in the dollar store packets, or the packets for 99 cents. So we get put the good stuff on here. New clips in. Now, get rid of this rotor. These are actually discontinued. They're Duralast GT. You can tell they're slotted rotors. They're brand new and they were sealed in plastic. Anytime you have new rotors, there's generally an anti-rust coating on them. So I like to get a shop towel, spray it down with brake cleaner, and get a little bit of stuff off of the contact patch anyway. All right, slip your new rotor in place. Caliper bracket. With the caliper bracket bolts that I just covered up. Ideally, you put thread locker back on these. But I'm just going to go bust nasty tight. All right. Now, we need to push back the caliper. The caliper piston. I like to use an old brake pad. Put backwards in there to push the piston back. I use this brake pad spreader tool, or brake caliper spreader tool, to push the pistons back in. Like I said, I know these weren't out very far, so it's kind of a bad example. These are still pretty good pads. Use the old pads because that little foot will dig into your new pad if you try to use your new pad. What am I doing? Forgot about the most important parts. Alright, there's a backing plate. It's not all of them have a backing plate that's removable. I like to either go spread this like so, there's an inner pad and an outer pad. The inside pad has that little squealer tab on it, okay? So that goes to the inside. And the outer pad goes out here. Slips right in the caliper bracket, right in your new clips. And look at that. Brake grease there. Now, caliper bolts. You slide in your freshly lubed guide pins. And like I said, 19 millimeter. Now the tire can go back on. One thing to double check is that your caliper can slide back and forth. You don't want it super tight on there. If it's tight, there's something in a bind. Even with brand new pads and brand new rotors. Even
with the brand new pads and brand new rotors. So yeah, they should have some.
Already, I think that looks a whole lot better than that. All right, guys, here's the rear brakes on 09 Tahoe. Now, this time the caliper bolts are they're a 13 millimeter, and the caliper bracket bolts are the same 18 millimeter. Caliper bolts here. Like I said, the head is 13 mil. These had some thread locker on them too. Now, pry on the caliper a little bit. Automatically felt a whole lot lighter. Like I said, these pads, they didn't need to be changed, but you know, they still had quite a bit of life left in them. But I didn't like these rotors. Caliper hang by the hose. Try to prop it up somewhere. Thank you.
the rears, you can see a whole lot more that rust on. So, once again, do the front side of the rotor first, and then you can set it on the hub flange without scratching it or getting it dirty or anything. All right, let's put the G up top. So that's clean. We'll do these shims real quick. Actually, these. The bottom one is a little gross. So, like I said, we will wipe them both off. Separate the pads, one with the squealer tab, one without. These look like they are different. There is a little bump on this one with the squealer tab, so just keep that in mind. So you can compare it side by side if there is something different about them. Looking at them, they all look the same to me. All right, caliper brackets ready to go back on. Thank you.
I was showing you earlier, you could actually pull the shim off the other ones. These are riveted on. So in that case, we just go right on top of that. It can be a little messy, but that's the only choice we really have. I'm gonna say the squealer tabs were on the inside. That's how they are about 90% of the time.
Getting ready to start the fronts.
The what?
Just getting ready to start the fronts. I guess as soon as I get done.
You're such a liar. Why are you gonna mess with me?
Because.
Here's the.
Little guy.
Can't tell me that better. Doesn't look better than that.